My name is Linzi Hosohama. I am here at UCLA in Amander Clark's lab. I am the lab technician and lab manager currently, and I have some germline projects where I differentiate embryonic stem cells into primordial germ cells in an in vitro model, and I'm now testing chemicals that the EPA has said they would like to look at to see how it affects the formation of our, you know, precursor cells that will eventually become our sperm and eggs. So in the lab, I differentiate, so I, you know, make embryonic stem cells become this primordial germ cell. It's an in vitro system, so everything is out of the body. It's actually in a hood. We work in hoods, which provide a very sterile environment. And basically from there, I culture these cells until they become the cell interest of choice. And then I take them and I analyze them for certain epigenetic marks. And basically what I'm finding is I'm adding some chemicals to my cells and I'm trying to see whether they can survive without this mark. And so far we've found that it can't. I think so little is known about this reproductive field right now, and you know, so many things can go right, so many things can go wrong, and yet, you know, you either make a baby or don't make a baby. And to me, that was something special within the division of science I felt was very intriguing. And after I kind of expressed that interest to my family, a couple of them actually came out and told me, you know, they've gone through IVF. They've tried different things to have babies. Some were successful. One of them has been trying for probably 4 or 5 years now, and she's still trying, and there's still so much to be learned, which is really why I'm interested. I wanted to join a field where it was very small, but it also interests me for personal reasons, and I can contribute to it in some significant way. What I'm specifically looking at within our germ cells is the epigenome. So some cancers or some other things that are going wrong in the body are not just caused by genetic defects, they're also being caused by epigenetic defects, which are just basically marks on your DNA that tell it when to, you know, go or stop, basically. It's become very interesting to me because I've, you know, been watching a lot of documentaries about the chemicals that we're exposed to now in the environment. I mean, we're exposed to upwards 10 to 10,000 chemicals a day. They're on everything. It's made me stop wanting to ask for receipts because receipts have a lot of BPA on it, and that's one of the chemicals that I study. You know, I've been interested in infertility for a very long time, and so now I'm, with my other interests in understanding the chemicals in our environment, I'm combining the two and really understanding how does it affect our, you know, reproductive ability. Because in my eyes, that's, you know, our number one goal and purpose of being on this earth. I am a scientist because I love science. I think that DNA and everything, you know, the RNA and the proteins it made and how it directs the cell and those cells interact with each other, and then all of a sudden we become an organism. I'm a walking and moving organism, and there's plant organisms that grow around me, there's animals, and we're all funnily made of the same four bases, but yet we're all so different and diverse, and to me that's amazing. And so I feel, you know, I'm very young and I kind of know where I want to go with my career, but I'm still very open-minded because science is so vast and huge and diverse, and I love talking to people about it. There's so many different topics that are at your disposal to learn about, and you know, whatever piques your interest, you can then decide, you know, I want to maybe find a lab that just studies that so I can learn more about it. I'm hoping that within my lifetime things change, and I want to be, you know, one of the people that helps instill that change.